when we take a job, don't go, think about this is my job. This is a passion. Football is my passion. I love this profession. So if you work like this, 100% we will be get the result. Not only instant result, but take time, we will get the result. Play more time in football, in the leg only, not in direct football. Play beautiful football. Even we want to go one system or we want to do something, believe yourself, you are the best.
Hello, captains of armband. Welcome to yet another episode of Short Corners, where we interview different managers, footballers, owners, scouts, and even analysts of different football teams to bring the various aspects of the game closer to you. So today with us, we have Mr. Bino George, the Santosh Trophy winning head coach of Kerala State football team. So, sir, has the feeling of winning the Santosh Trophy has sunk in yet?
Yeah, it is, after 26 years, in the hosting team, conducting the Kerala, after 26 years, we have won the Santosh Trophy. It in happening in Kerala, that means hosting. But 2017, 18, we won in Calcutta. Those were the final match. So after that, after COVID, we come back strongly. Not only Santosh Trophy, most of the old championship in Kerala.
So, sir, especially with the audience, there was a lot of pressure, and it has to be said that Kerala team has just performed brilliantly and secured the trophy, sir. So, sir, you grew up at a household with strict rules, and despite getting no support from the family, you chose to become a footballer. You once said, "Football was my passion, a sport that could help you forget all your sorrows." After all these years, do you still view the game the same way?
Yeah, sure. Because, most of the, even not only Kerala, in India, most of the footballers behind for poor family, even for my side, the ground is very nearby my home, only 1/2 kilometer from my house. So even, I am Vijayan nearby my house. He is my role model because I usually saw his game, his senior players, most of the players from my locality, C.V. Papachan, Jopol Ancheri, most of the players, you can't imagine. So I am watching this senior players game regularly, and my nearby my ground is very near to the ground. So this is my motivation. Even though, my father was expired in one age of 1.5 year. My younger brother is only 90 days. So, very difficult that time to manage the footballing because, mother is very strict. 6 o'clock, I want to come back to the home. Otherwise, it is, he locked the gate. It is very difficult. So my home is in town only, when I get the small gap, I love this game because that time I don't know about I'm a big coach, I'm a big player. I don't think like that. I love the game. So when we playing, when we can get the game of football, when we lose, when we win, sometimes when we use the tricks, when we use the brain, all will become within football. When the winning movement, the sorrow movement, so the decision making, this is a, it is. Well, that's why the football is a popular game, world popular game.
So, sir, after retiring as a footballer, you did your postgraduate in physical education at Kannur University and a one-year football coaching course at NIS Patiala before joining Viva Kerala as the assistant coach to A.M. Sridharan. What were some of the early lessons that you learned during that job and how did that shape you as a manager?
After my knee injured, so I am simply sitting in my home, and one of my friends told me there is a one option, Binu, if you pass a degree, that's why there is a one option, any degree, you can join one physical education PG course. So I that time my age was 30 because when I played the national level, so I get the 5 year consumption because only 25 year is the cut limit. So I played the national, that's why I got the 5 year exemption. So I joined the course PG. there only I got the interest. So coaching is good. When I know the knowledge, if I give some good boys, so that is of my first my thinking. When if you become a coach, maybe good or bad, I don't know. So I joined there, and after that, my PG 2 year PG I did in Kannur. So I went there Kannur Patiala Punjab. So this is my training point. No, so after come back. Still, I don't know about the full depth in football, professional football, no? So there is a one coach, you know, A.M. Sridharan. He was FC coach in Kerala Police. He was best coach that time. So he called me, Binu, if you are interested, you come and join Viva Kerala. So after that, what happened? I joined Viva Kerala. We qualified for the I-League. Then I am in the age of 30 or 31. I am traveling flight. I am staying in 5-star hotel. I am playing with the big clubs. So I, this is my passion started. So I love football because I was studying regarding making more books and more reading the books. And I experimented some players. And you know, that time, you know, Sabir, Shabazz Salil, even Viva Vineet, some MP Sakir. A lot of players played in India and big clubs. So this was the turning point. So I get more experience because from 2006 to 2011, I was assistant coach because three more, all head coach may be sacked. I am always there because I am working hard. The management know this boy is very good. They're working hard. He want to interest it. But I'm not looking for a salary because I want to learn. So I work after CAM Sridharan. I work with Pakir Ali, Nizam Pakir Ali. He was a Sri Lankan national team coach, and I work with Subhash Bhowmick from Calcutta. So this kind of who is a good, I will take bad, I will take, yeah. So I get the experience from this kind of working more 6 years, no, five, six, almost 6 years. I work with assistant coach. This is one of the best experience for me to getting knowledge, to getting more idea about professional football.
I would just like to add on to your answer. As you have said, it's very important that you take the leap rightly from being a player to a manager. But one thing I was just itching to ask for a long time, you stayed at Viva Kerala for nearly 6 years as an assistant coach. And during that period, as you have said, you worked with Mr. Pakir Ali and Mr. Subhash Bhowmick. How did these iconic coaches impact your life and career as a whole?
See, even, you know, it is some kind of their ideas, their discipline in football, how to handle with the big players. So this kind of some knowledge I get from these big coaches, you know, I'm not blaming any coaches because before old years, what happened? There is no big tactics. Nowadays, the tactics come where to defend, how to defend, what is the duty, what is the responsible of the all positions. So that time there is nothing to coaches explain, you know. And nowadays, you know, coach should be a good knowledgeable person. See, when the student will be asked, coach, why are we doing this? They have Google. No, if you Google, they get the answer. If the coach is wrong, coach is shame in front of the boys. So right nowadays, you know, coach is more knowledgeable about the subject. So that before the old days, what happened? They're simply playing. That's why I'm said good thing I will be take, bad thing I forget it. Yeah. So all these kind of coaches, they have their own ideas, their own experience. I help this kind of the Viva Kerala coaching life.
In 2017, you joined the current I-League champions Gokulam Kerala as their head coach. In your first season, you did not get enough quality Indian players to compete professionally with the big guns of the I-League. So how did you deal with that challenge both tactically and mentally?
See, what happened in 2017, when I was in, after the Viva Kerala the Calcutta people buy the Viva Kerala. It's a Chirag Kerala. So only 1 year they did. After that they give up. No. So there is no club in Kerala. So I was joined Kerala State Sports Council that time. So I worked with 2-3 years. Then after 2017, Mr. Praveen, that means in the son-in-law of Gokulam Gopalan, is the main man behind the Gokulam FC. So he phoned me, Binu, I want to make a one team because Kerala Blaster have been playing in ISL. So why should we? So you are the right person for me. I will send a flight ticket. Their head office in Chennai. Chennai. So he sent a flight ticket to me. Binu, you come and come to my office. And we discussed and he said, I have only limited budget because this is a starting season. Already the I-League closed because all team is confirmed. So most time you don't get the I-League. But we are trying for a corporate entry. But the all windows, everything closed. But not sure, but you make a one team. So what happened? I started to search my players. I already said all interviews. I have philosophy. Those who are the players want, football is a big game. So nowadays, all watching English Premier League, Spanish League, they like that kind of game. No, so my philosophy is football is beautiful game. Not only win, we want to make one system. So that kind of when we are making a story, that time they decided who will be hero, who will be heroine, because the best hero will become only the pitcher will be a success. Otherwise, pitcher flop. The same thing in football. If you make my style of play, the player I discover and I bring and I make. That time only the Gokulam Praveen told me, Binu, this is my budget, only near about 1 crore. 1 crore, not too much. So you want to make. So I make Arjun Jayaraj, Rashid, all young players. Even I bring Lakra from Calcutta, Sandhu Singh from Calcutta, some this kind of players. These small boys, they nobody knows them. Nobody knows them. They are all young boys. So even that time, unexpected what happened, Praveen get a cooperative entry. The window is closed. Window is closed. The first 6 matches, we losing all matches like 1-0, 2-0, 3-0. After the second window opened, one of my friend, we did together in pro license. He helped me from Uganda. There is one player I can bring you. That is Hendrik Sieke. So I bring him and we started each losing the match, I will watch again what is the mistake. I am explaining my boys and but my system is not my system is same. After that year we secured 7th position. Instead of 12 team, we secured the 7th position and we beat Mohun Bagan, we beat East Bengal, we beat Minerva and we make a nickname Jane Killers. Jain Killers, because we are a small budgeted team. So this is my good experience for Gokulam. So I am the first staff Gokulam. I bring Gokulam, and after next year, I make Praveen told me, Binu, you make a technical director. He bring one foreign coach, Fernando Valera. In between Fernando, again he lose he because of language, and again I was a head coach. So again, I maintained the position like 5-6. So because of small budget, that year only 2 crore or 1.5 crore. But nowadays, budget increase, players increase. Even my president said, Binu, why you not change the head coach? Because, India, even if I go some sponsor, if a white people come, they will get their sponsorship, it is not for you are coaching bad. You are a good coach. You are a good man. So this kind of things happening in India because I always staying my interviews. Even Calcutta University, you take a degree. Kerala, I take a degree. The content is same, right? Even UFA pro license and AFC pro license content is same. The subject is different. Subject means they're getting good players, we getting not that much good standard. If we getting good players, we can do it. So I always saying Indian coaches are good, not bad. All are same. But how to manage, how to you describe the players, how to handle the players, this kind of, this is happening in India. So after that, see, we make a women's team. I made a women's team. After long 5 years, 4.5 years, I worked with Gokulam. And I said, Praveen, I want to go for coaching. Coaching is my passion. I doesn't want to sit in like a technical director. So even this year, you know, the Gokulam is now again champion. It's all my boys, you know, Emil Benny, I bring. Alex Saji, I bring. Rishad, I bring. Even most of the players is my, I bring only. See, the players have contract. Because I know each player, each places, those who have good in football. That is my scouting.
So the one thing that I like the most about the whole point is that at India, a lot of emphasis is given on bringing in coaches from outside. But in Indian coaches have also done a brilliant job. As you said, someone like Mr. Khalid Jamil, he just made the team from a lower spot to just qualify into the ISL playoffs and things like this. He also became an I-League champion and also that. So sometimes you just need the backing. And another thing that I would just like to ask, you said the footballing philosophy. So what is the word footballing philosophy means to you?
In my footballing philosophy, catch the young players, make them big level. And see, my philosophy in the game, play more time in football, in the leg only, not in direct football. Play beautiful football. And catch the young players, make a good style of play. This is what you make a one system. That's why the football they love. So this is my philosophy, bring good young players and more time want to play in the play open court, play with the short passing, play with the technique more strong. This kind of, I'm looking for this.
That's a very interesting explanation, sir, that just play, catching the footballers young and developing them is one of the most key components in your footballing philosophy. So, sir, as you mentioned in the previous answer,
always stick on our system, you know, always stick on system, because some, you know, sometimes the win is 100%. But I said, even all team management, I need more time, not a short-term project. I want more than 3 years, because then only we can budding, the system will be, we can implement. You know, short passes, more possession, and a good option to repeat the action. If you stop first man, go pressing. Like, you know, this is a modern football. If you play like this, we can some, see, first time don't get the result. But you work on same thing, you repeat on this, 100% I believe we get the result.
So, sir, coming to the philosophy, another big question. Gokulam Kerala's women's side is the best in the country, and that's without a question. So what was the idea behind the formation of the women's team at the club, and how did it excel to such magnanimous proportions?
Even our chairman Gokulam Gopalan sir is a full-hearted man. See, he said, why only men? We want to go, we will, men and women are same in the right now. So we want to start a women's team. That is possible. So Praveen again asked me, Ebinu, you bring one good coach. And we, at that time, you know, my batchmate was Priya. Priya is my batchmate. So we are good friends. So I called her and I asked which player we want. Same, we want to make a system. The system, we want to play more possession game. Even same like a men. So Praveen support me. Praveen said, Bino, this is the budget. So this budget, including you want to make a good team. And only one foreigner we can play. First issues, two season, our result is, first season, our result is zero. Second season, we reach a semi-final. Third season we won the IWL. Then we go AFC Cup. So this is same. We love not only men football, not both are same in Kerala. You know, mother, if I believe mother of the sports is athletics. Mother of the sports is athletics. So, you know, in Kerala, you know, P.T. Usha, Shiny Abraham, even more athletics people in Kerala because the running, you know. So why we? So now Gokulam, now government, with the support of government, Gokulam started a women's academy. Even with the support of government, Blasters started a men's academy. So now Kerala is developing. Even this kind of motivation, government also supporting the clubs, supporting the younger players. Even see, the more coaches will become, more teams will become. So this is a developing, no? So I hope Kerala and Kerala is on the right track.
So sir, how important is it for Indian coaches to come at the grassroots level, at the academy level, so that they can also move up along with the players? Because the more the number of Indian coaches, the more I think the footballing ecosystem will also develop. So what do you think on, sir, producing more Indian coaches right now? Should be a priority or not?
See, even you know, this is my point of my views only. See, you know, in Kerala, even not only Kerala, even India, in grassroots level, that is 11, 12 age is a golden period of the young boy. Golden period, that is the technique want to learn from this age only. So in India, this age, the knowledge, the big coaches want to coach these boys. Now what happening in India? There is a small salary, but those who are coaching that age, very zero technical coaches in coaching. That means only D license coaches, only C license coaches. Why pro license coach go to coach this kind of academy? Why A license coach go? Because if I want to go, if I am a pro license, I want to go coach, I have no problem. But money is the issue. I spend 7 lakh for a 7 to 8 lakh to spend a pro license, and getting 15,000 rupees per month for a grassroots, how I can go? So government, that philosophy, government, this kind of, we want to change. You want to pay big money to the big coaches and coach them young, good boys. Then we get the good players. All over the India, this is happening. Only D-license coaches, all those who are not technically good, that kind of coaches is coaching in our future talent. You understand what my point? Even you know, in Sedan, he hit the head for Materazzi in the final. The punishment of France Football Federation is, what is the punishment, you know? To coach young boys for 3 months. That is punishment. So good players, good quality, senior players, those who have played India, those who have played a big players, give them license. And let them go and coach this period. You understand? The quality coaches, quality players go coach this kind of period. Then we get the good players in future.
Since some of our previous podcasts, many coaches from the age group came in our show, and they always said the word just you just repeated today, that the age of 10 to 14 is the most important period for a young football player. It is the time where all the tactics, technicalities just drilled into them. So the most important age for a player to develop is that age. And so it is the most important age. And whether it be the association or the academy, this should be the age group that should give in the most priority if you want the team or the club or the even the country to develop. So they have already said this.
This period, we appoint as a good coaches. That is my point. Not only D-license coach, not only E-license coach, please appointment A-license coach or pro-license coach. Those who are talent coaches. Because they get, you see, smaller age we learn, we will, don't forget, we will be, that is the improvement of Europeans. You understand?
Yes, sir. Especially in the European academies, we often see that the biggest, the good, the best coaches just coach this age to develop this branch of player. Because at this age, you know, that player is a prodigy. That player will not might make into the professional side, or this guy would just be a professional. So this is the most important.
One of the example, when I was in Gokulam, the professional level, top level, those who are players come, I have no time to go for technique. Only the professional side only will go for tactics only. See, so I waste my time. Some boys, even we go for a set pieces, we said, you first post, you kick a first post. But when we kick, the ball will be go second or ball will be go ground. This is the problem of the technique. The boy want to learn from this, the period of usage. You understand? So yes, that time we go for a good coaches behind this and learn from the coaches, from the students. See, this we want to change in India. So their coaches want to pay good money, they will be good, 100%.
The more the investment in the lower age groups and the grassroots development, the more the better footballers will grow up. Not only the development of the equipment, rather than the wages of the coaches, wages to the players. So that's a very important point, and sir, you rightly pointed out that.
Yeah. True.
So, sir, in 2019, you were named the technical director of the club, as you said. Could you give us a bit more insight into your role as the technical director? And what were some of the activities that you just implemented while keeping the long-term vision of the club in mind?
So, that time, we make one reserve team, that is developing team. They're playing in Kerala League. So I scouted all over the Kerala. I started to scout the young boys, and I signing for that boys are, you see, Emil Benny, all come from Emil Benny, Alex, all from the reserve team. And I started a women's team, and I started under 13, under 14 academies. And even I around go for a senior team scouting for the coaches, philosophy players. I work a lot. We have make one system. We build a office. We started more. Gokulam have more schools. More colleges. We started coaching them there. We started a system. So that's why I see. Even the last day of my service in Gokulam, I said, Praveen, I just want to go for coaching. That's why. And Praveen said, Binu, you have always one chair for here. Anytime you can come back. Gokulam, the last match of I-League, he sent a flight ticket and I'll come Calcutta and watch the I-League final against Mohammedan Sporting. So because they're still, I made a team, no? So I love still Gokulam, I love always. Because wherever my professional, right now I am working in a Kerala United. Same level, I want to bring the Kerala United in other club. Because, more clubs will become, players get the opportunity, players with the competition, then only football develop. So still the same path on Kerala United, also same path. You see, this year Santosh Trophy, 6 players we played in Kerala United players. Most of the players getting big clubs offer. So same, my philosophy is always, now Praveen said, Binu, I am missing, because you make good players from Kerala United. So this is football, then only develop.
Yes, sir. The competition has a very important part to play in football, and more the club, the more the competition, more the rivalry, the better the players they will come. So, sir, now coming to the Santosh Trophy. Sir, in the same year, the Kerala State football team appointed you as their head coach. And this year, you have led them to the Santosh Trophy victory, which is always talked about. Looking back at these last 3 years, which decisions do you think have proven to be a game changer for you as the state team head coach?
See, what happened in 2017, we are the champion of Santosh Trophy. So after 2018, we not qualify for the final round. First round we lose against some
Pondicherry, tournament happened in Pondicherry, we not qualify. So 2019, all Kerala Football Association executives, all they had a meeting. After that, unanimous, they selected one person name, my name. They said, Binu, we 2019, like 2020, because you want to take charge of Santhosh Trophy. So I said, I was a technical director of Gokulam Kerala FC. So I said, Santhosh Trophy is a job, there is a no salary, you know. It's a prestigious job. I said, if you want, I want to come Santhosh Kerala state team coach. First, you want to take a permission from our director, that is Mr. Praveen. If you agree, I can come. So Praveen said, Binu, you can go. It is our Kerala. It is a Kerala, for Kerala only you going. So you can go Santhosh Trophy, but only one condition. When you come back, I want good players with our club. So I said, that is definitely, sir, because I bring my club only, no? So I will 100% I will bring the players. So the permission of Mr. Praveen, I take charge of Kerala Santhosh Trophy. Even I said, in there, most of the, you know, Kerala have more footballers, you know, so more good players. But only I said the Kerala Football Association, I want independent decision. Those who are no recommendation, nothing. I decide all players. You can, after, if you lose or win, you can blame me. So I can take responsibility. So Kerala Football Association Secretary Mr. Anil Kumar, that is, you can decide anything. I will not interrupt for your job. So he said, so I'm happy, Anil Kumar, because he support me a lot. So I take, for my style of play, you know, my philosophy players I selected. And we played the match in Calicut in our Gokulam home ground only. 2020, I'm saying. 1920. So we beat all team like Tamil Nadu, Andhra, all big margin, and we qualified for the final round. For that time, final round happening in I think Aizwal. So because of COVID, the match is abandoned. So it's stopped. But 2 years there is no match. So team qualified for the final round. So the match is because of COVID, can't possible. So this year, again, Praveen, Kerala Football Association, again phoned me. Binu, last time we can't go for final round. So again, we are requesting, please come and join, take the charge of Kerala Santhosh Trophy. So I said, please, because I am working in Southern Club, Kerala United FC. So they're a big, not like a Gokulam, they are all owners behind from abroad. So it is very difficult to come. If they agree, I can come. So even same thing they said, Mr. Shabir Manari, he was a CEO of Kerala United. He said, he from Kerala only. He said, coach, no problem, you can go. You take the permission. And again, I am take the charge. Same group. So again, I selected the same, my philosophy players. There is very difficult to getting, you know, all, not only Kerala, all players same like that. Even ISL, I-League players can't play for a Santhosh Trophy. So I am searching, because, you know, this time we are conducting in Kerala, that the loving place of football in Malappuram, especially in the Malappuram, there is a crazy in football. They love football, their blood is football. Because the place we are playing, so I know the play, those who are coming, big crowd, 100%. So we want to make a good attacking football, because I am always like that only, attacking football only. My philosophy is like that. Because keep ball position in open half and play like possession football, more possession and score goal. So there is a difficulty in getting, but after that first round, I some position there is a lacking, so it helped Kerala Premier League. That time Kerala Premier League is conducted here, so I get a 2-3 players from Kerala Premier League. It will be help for me, Kerala League, help, very helpful. So I take that kind of place. And my strong point was a more midfielder, you know, Jijo Joseph, Arjun Jayaraj, and Mohammad Rashid. This kind of players I make. And I made a system, and only I get a 20-23 days. Most of the time, I'll go for tactics only. I'll give the responsibility, duties, where they defend, how they defend, what is their duty. Most of the time, more video classes, more motivating videos. Like, more, see, only professional level I do with the amateur Santosh Trophy, you know. So, because I have responsibility, I said always, we are playing against the big place of Malappuram. So most crowd will be come. Your name will be changed because you 100%, you know, you can't believe the people, those who are come and support us because of they love our game. They like our game. If we won the match very badly, like direct football, next game they doesn't come. They doesn't support. So I said, we want the, we are, there is a system, a philosophy. We want to play like that. Then each game, you know, we dominated all game. In final match only, we just freak because, you know, second time we play against Bengal, they learn our strong point and catch them and they stop. So even what happened second half, I change my plan. I use more wing because they stop my midfielder Jijo Joseph, Arjun, they stop. But I use second half, I use more wings, and I, instead of one striker, I put in two. So that's why we get a more chances we created, but badly we missed the chances. This kind of I did it in Santosh Trophy.
The Santosh Trophy final was a sight to behold, and the quality of football from the both sides were brilliant. And as far as I remember, I was watching the game and thinking that the match had quality superior than some of the I-League and ISL games. It was so brilliant. There were very few missed passes. The both teams were playing fluently. And that was a very, very good game to just watch as a whole. So, sir, before the Santosh Trophy final against the 32 times champion West Bengal, how did you prepare the players both mentally and tactically?
See, I 2014, I worked with the Bengal in Calcutta United Sports Club, because most of the players I know that Bengal playing, even Monotosh Chakradar was the captain of the team, and the Pyan Singh, they both are played in Gokulam Kerala FC before when I was coach. So I know the character of Bengali football players. Even see, they for footballing they have crooked mind, you know. So they have good experience, because Calcutta League is not like a Kerala. It's a very tough league. They want to survive all positions. But I learned my boys this kind of what they're doing. We want to overcome that. I learned only this. What is they do? Maybe they do. I taught plan B. If you play like this, we will go like this. All, most of the classes from 2-3 time and video section only. Because, I show some good moves from Bengals and how to the stop, where we'll go penetrate, where we want to press. If you press, this kind of more, I use tactics only. So that's why I'm said, Bengal, I 100% I know, they'll be... stop our main strong point. That's why final I said no. They stop our Jijo Joseph, Arjun Jayaraj, because most of the time we use on penetrate ball in the center zone. So they stop it. They play more defensive, and they get the ball. They use the counter attack. So we first half we also struggled. Then after that I'll go dressing room. I spoke. I draw the in the board, and I learned. See, now we go for a plan B, because we use more flank, and instead of one striker I put a two. Then after that we get a 2-3 open chances. Unfortunately we not converted, but even see penalty come. Even my all changes, only remaining 3 minutes only remaining, my my change will be score the equalizer goal, Safnath, because I changed him. I think extra time only I put him the substitution. See, even the penalty come, we decided give them number one number. My coaches, some of the managers told me, no coach, please, those who are confident, they go and take kick. So I said, no, we give the number one, this guy, Mr. Sanju, go one, this give the number. So they did it well. Because we planned well, because we worked hard for the Santosh Trophy, because, you know, at least after I said the people, those who are coming and support, you know, that time the fasting of Muslims, Ramadan is going on. No, so I said the people, those who are coming and supporting us, we want to give the gift for the people, come and support us. So by the grace of God, everything will be did well. My boy, I thank my boys, because when I said in the classroom, teacher is teaching or coaching, they implement, when the examination come, they write the same thing, only they pass. Okay, but what I learned, I give them instruction, their duty and responsibility, they did well. They executed well in the ground. So, thank you, players, and thank you, those who are support.
So, one thing you said that Mallappuram was a crazy footballing state. So, sir, the team was playing in the home ground. There was huge expectations of Kerala. So, how did the team manage the pressure of expectation from the fans as well?
See, being Kerala was very important with all crowd, you know. They love football, because I said before, the Mallappuram, the place is, you know, it's a Malabar area. They love football more than all heart, they are football. They breathe football, they love football. That's why, you know, 8 o'clock match, they come in the stadium 2 o'clock and fill the seats 2 o'clock, because they know, the capacity is not too much. So those who are come first, they get the seat. You understand? So I had tremendous support from KFA, Kerala Football Association, and they give full freedom to me, to the players' decision, and what I order, they'll be help me. And even the government, you know, this time government conducted directly take the tournament from All India Football Federation, and the government said also, they will be support me, or even all players. So this kind of helping all together, like make a family, we did it.
So sir, for a team to succeed, it's extremely important to have a set of values that in turn team into a team culture. We often say that if a culture is strong enough, the new people who would come to the team would just get well accustomed to the culture of the side. And if the culture is weak, it has a problem with the player settling in. So what are some non-negotiable values of the Kerala State football team that set the culture, and how do you maintain the team culture in the group as well?
So, you know, I already mentioned, because most of the players I know, they train under me, even not only the club, when the college level also, they train me under me. So I selected my players in my culture, my philosophy, my style of play. So even they know about not only the Santosh Trophy players, even those who are in Kerala, we Kerala have one culture. They love football, because most of the players have more technically they good. You understand? Because, you know, in Kerala and Bengal also, there is most 7-side tournament is happening. So in 7-side means only the small sided game. The small sided, what is the benefit? More time ball in the feet. Always the small mistake will be get more ball reach faster. So the most of the crowd, the fear will be gone. So this kind of sevens tournament help the they make, there is a one culture in football culture in Kerala, Bengal, even Goa. So I am for in only, I think in my point of my concern, Kerala only the long. A long way they use same system. Kerala players only playing Kerala Santosh Trophy, not even one Bengal player playing in Gokulam FC. We not selected for a Bengal players or Punjab players, other not other selected other state players, only Kerala players. Even Karnataka, some Manipuri boys will be playing in Karnataka.
Even I don't know, first time Bengal or most of the players from Bengal only. But before, you know, Danson Devadas in Kerala, he played in Bengal team. Even IM Vijayan played Bengal team. But in Kerala, there is nothing happened. Only Kerala boys only can play the Kerala team. So Kerala have their culture, their system is there. So I'm very easy for this. But only style of play, that is, I can manage. That's all.
So, sir, now coming to the final question. What advice will you like to give to all the aspiring football coaches around the globe?
See, enjoy the football. See, even we want to go system or we want to do something, believe yourself. You are the best. Understand? Believe yourself. And see, you make a dream. I want to do this. Only for me, only for himself only can do something, not others. So stick on our philosophy. Stick on the result is important 100%. So you see, when we take a job, don't think about this is my job. This is a passion. Football is my passion. I love this profession. So if you work like this, 100% we will get the result. Not only instant result, but take time, we will get the result. So stick on, main thing, see, the discipline, the passion, the hard work, the focus, the goal. This, we want to set the plan.
A quick shout out to our merchandise partner, Midfield Merchandise. If you want to buy quality 100% cotton t-shirts, stickers and lapel pins at affordable prices, Midfield Merchandise is the place to visit. Upon applying this coupon code, you will get a special 30% discount on your purchases. The link to the site and the coupon code are also given in the description below.
So, captains, that was all for today. We need to end our session here. Thanks to Mr. George for being with us today. To all our viewers, thanks a lot for tuning in. Make sure to subscribe to our channel for more such podcasts like this. Until next time, it's goodbye from Armband.